number 35, Joshua Moyer, a junior from Ellentown, PA. In midfield for the Knights, number 1, Thomas Smith, a junior from Grosse Pointe Farms, Michigan. Number 20, Christian Kohler, a junior from Ionia, New York. And number 28, Jordan Warner, a freshman from Orange, California. In defense for the Knights, number 13, Micah Vandenberg, a senior from Lowell, Michigan. Number 22, Josh Gage, a junior from Livonia, Michigan. Number 23, Ethan Bolins, a senior from Round Lake, Illinois. And in goal to say no for your Knights, number 21, Corgan Schomberg, a senior from Rockton, Illinois. The head coach for the Knights is David Hoger, assisted by Bob Evans, Chad Wright, Yevgeny Gilorkin, and Scott Opel. Today's NCAA officials to the game are Brett Savacha, Jesse Reed, and Terry Williams. And now, ladies and gentlemen, it's time to watch the fastest game on 2 feet.
All right, ready to go. And we got Nate Hansen in the face-off circle. And he was there with Zach Kayava, and North Central's Kayava wins that one. So North Central in the black uniforms, trimmed in red and white. A turnover by the Cardinals, and here comes Kelvin quickly the other way. In transition, Carpenter right in on net, and a save by the goalie, Aiden Murphy.
Now we have ground ball 12.
Kelvin in possession.
That was fast. That was
Brandon Innigenberg had it a moment ago. David Blackman behind the net.
I can see, yeah, it's fine. I mean, I'm never going to be able to see to that far corner, but I can see I can't see the close corner, but even if you weren't there.
Thomas Smith coming in from the left wing. North Central coming off a 12-8 win over the University of Dubuque on Wednesday night. Kelvin has been idle since last Saturday when they beat Benedictine by that same identical 12-8 score. 2-game win streak for the Knights, and again, as I mentioned, North Central is 7-0. Pass into the slot. Kohler, a shot, and a goal! A left-handed dart. And Kohler draws first blood for the Knights.
First blood drawn by Christian Kohler with the assist from David Blackman.
Jack Kayava, the 5'9 senior at a White Bear Lake, Minnesota, going head to head against Nate Hansen. Hansen again named MIAA Specialist of the Week, second time this year he has earned that award. Came back this past Monday. We're going to have a face-off violation on North Central, and Kelvin will win that one. So Kelvin with possession again after grabbing the 1-0 lead. Hansen bowling his way through the right wing. Goes behind the net. And what do we have here? Something with a shot clock, maybe? Looks like maybe the... Something with a clock, I want to say. We're having a little chat over there with our table crew. Shot clock is at 65 right now. That football building... behind the north goal is really starting to come into play. They are building that in anticipation being ready for August 1. And then, of course, you start to see across the way behind the team benches for Lacrosse here, the grandstand is starting to go up with this Zytema Field. They're hoping to have everything done and dusted sometime by next October. The steel is coming in. The concrete starting to go up. Exciting times. And really blessed to have this turf field for this 2023-24 academic year. You think about a day like today where we had a lot of rain overnight. If we had had a grass field, it would have been tough sledding as far as a grass field footing and the field staying firm and that type of thing. But with turf, we just keep right on a moving. Had it come into play quite a bit this fall with soccer. Very rainy fall, and they are really fortunate to have this field. Here's Kelvin. A shot. on the attack, and they'll hang on to it. It was Riley DeSarbo who passed it off. That shot was by Griffith. 45 on the shot clock right now. DeSarbo and Joshua Moyer out of Allentown, Pennsylvania. Talked to Joshua a couple of times this week. He is really excited for this matchup. Here's a shot by Gage, and that one is going to fly wide of the goal, a little bit left. Kelvin will maintain possession. Blackman, the sophomore out of Wheaton, Illinois. Speaking of Wheaton, Kelvin softball is supposed to be down there for a doubleheader today, but the rain washed out the field, so they will not make up that one. It's canceled. Turnover by Kelvin, and a ground ball picked up by the Cardinals. Dylan Anderson, and a clearing attempt here for North Central. North Central of the CCIW, College Conference of Illinois and Wisconsin. Of course, Kelvin out of the MIAA, Michigan Intercollegiate Athletic Association. North Central located in Naperville, Illinois. A real power when it comes to cross country and track, and then recently have really come on in football. They've won a couple of national titles on the football side, lost in the finals this year, so national runners up. Joey DeCunha has it, left-hander, trying to spin his way in. There's a shot from the point, and it's going to go wide and high. Riley McQueary, North Central has it, 26 ticks on the shot clock. Rain has blown away, but it's still an overcast, damp afternoon. Pass out in front, deflected, and it'll be a cause turnover, and Ethan Bullens with a ground ball. Clear attempt for the Knights. Not sure who we're going to give the cause turnover there. A couple of players look like they got a stick on it. Looks like Josh Gage will get the turnover created by Kelvin, or the cause turnover on your stat sheet. So the Knights setting up shop in the half-court offense, or half-field offense. I'm going to say half-court. Here's a shot by Smith and a goal! He went down low to the right-hand corner, and he beat Aiden Murphy. He saw that opening, and Smith is about 6'3" or 6'4". He's got that long reach, so I think the goalie is always going to look high initially, and when he went low, the goalie just could not react and get the stick down,
Kelvin goal,
and the net down quickly enough to stop it. So a 2-0 lead for Kelvin, 4.5 minutes in. Another face-off, and Kelvin has had a lot of the ball early on as far as possession is concerned. Hansen wins that face-off, the Diesel. A face-off win, and again, as I just mentioned, Kelvin possessing the ball. Sometimes the best offense is best defense is a good offense. So very high scoring North Central offensive attack, but they have not had the ball a whole lot. It's Carpenter behind the goal. Now setting up shop with Jordan Warners, the freshman out of California, spinning. Trying to work his way in, goes up top to Smith. Using that frame and then got bumped off the ball, but Johnny on the spot was Christian Kohler. Gets the ground ball. David Blackman, about 6'4", another big, tall frame. See him walking around the Spoelhof Fieldhouse complex, the atrium area there. And he is a good-sized young man, I can tell you that. He has got some length. Here's a shot from the point. It's going to go wide. That was Joshua Moyer. 5 on the shot clock, so Kelvin's going to have to make something happen real fast. In fact, they're just going to turn it over and set up shop on defense, and not necessarily a bad option as it allows your defense to get back in the deep cover two, if you will, the umbrella defense, and not allow the transition opportunity for North Central. North Central with a successful clear. It's Luke Ilgen who had it a moment ago. Pass behind the net. Moving his way on in is DeCunha. Shot was saved by Schomburg, the goalie. North Central maintains possession. 60 on the shot clock. McQuarrie finds Charlie Snyder. Back to DeCunha. Twisting, turning McQuarrie. Kelvin staying very disciplined on the defensive end. Tom Eberhardt. Going back behind the net. 32 on the shot clock. Pass through the slot, and it's going to go wayward and out of bounds. A turnover. And Kelvin's going to get the ball back, and the bench is very excited. Long bomb pass across the field, and it'll be successful to Micah Vandenberg, fifth-year senior. Now that pass is going to be intercepted, a turnover by the Knights, and here comes North Central the other way. Rutger Rawlings with it. And the Cardinals on the clear. Gavin Rieger jukes a man. And one hops it on the ground and out of bounds as the Knight defense pressuring in and creating the turnover. So a couple of early turnovers by North Central. Kelvin's defense has been very disciplined. Nick Griffith out of Oviedo, Florida. Through the left wing. Trying to turn his way on in. Got hit, but was able to pick up the loose change. Pass up high and couldn't get it to, I'm not sure if that was Blackman or Smith who got laid out. And he is down on the turf. And time will be called. North Central has possession and time called as, I think that's Nick Griffith, who was down, a little slow to get up. He got belted pretty good and might have gotten the wind knocked out of him. Good to see him up on his feet and walking off with the training staff. Always a bit risky to run through that slot, reach up high for a pass when you've got two or three defenders there to undercut you. It's like a receiver in football trying to go up on a scrum and reach up high for a pass with a whole bunch of defensive backs clawing at them and ready to take you out. Got to have some intestinal fortitude to make an offensive play like that. North Central on the clear. It's a good one. DeCunha with it. Coming right in on net and a goal. Going top shelf, Charlie Snyder. He beat a couple of defenders and
North Central goal
at the near post.
Snyder with the assist from
he went up high and beat Schomburg, making it 2-1. Quick snapshot. Dylan Anderson for North Central. Go head-to-head with Hansen. 6:07 left, first quarter. 2-1, Kelvin. And Hansen's going to win that one. The third face-off win for Kelvin in this game. Carpenter trying to beat his man inside. He'll back it off and get it to Joshua Moyer. Behind the net. Jordan Warner's running point right now. All right. Carpenter had a scoop and scramble and came up with that one. Now here's Smith. Trying to use a right-hand shoulder shot and a good save deflected by the goalie. Aiden Murphy. Yeah, I was going to say shot clock probably should have reset, but apparently was not on goal. I thought it was, but here's Carpenter from the point, and that one's going to go wide. Kelvin will maintain possession now, about 26 in the shot clock. Knights getting off some shots at goal right now. Here we go, Warners. Up top, trying to crank it was Carpenter, and it flew out of his basket. Pass in the slot. Oh, Moyer got whacked. He lost the ball there. Be a turnover, and North Central on the clear. Got his helmet partially knocked off. Recovers to get back up. Here come the Cardinals. Ooh, a near steal by Carpenter. That's McQuarrie. We'll bring it in to the attacking third. And what do we have? Offside call on North Central. Turnover. Brett Savaccia, our head official, made that call. Good move at midfield. Allows the Knights to break the pressure right there. That was Kohler. Now Blackman. Crossfield pass. Too tall for Smith. And out of bounds. Turnover Knights. So here comes North Central again. Joey DeCunha on the attack. He'll set it up. Ryland McQuarrie gets the handoff with just under 4 minutes to go first quarter. Pretty good crowd here on Easter weekend. Here's a shot from the point and a good save. Schaumburg got a piece of that. And they'll reset the shot clock. That thing was headed just inside the post there, and he got a piece of it. It's a good save. DeCunha shot, and it's going to go wide just from the right of the surrounding semicircle in front of the net. Crease area. North Central maintains possession. Pass out in front. No one there, and comes back to the point picked up by the Cardinals. Charlie Snyder has it. Left-handed shot, well wide, into the snowbank. And North Central maintains possession. 37 ticks left on the shot clock. 3:20 on the game clock.
It's whoever's closest to the ball, yeah. Where it goes out, yeah. It's on the shot.
Yep.
Long bomb pass up and over. Riley McQuarrie's heading a turnover for the Cardinals. Kelvin will get the ball back. Let's see if they can get a shot on goal. Ooh, pass out of bounds by Kelvin. That was a turnover on Bolins. Don't see him do that often. Comes up on the defensive end. And knocks it loose, creates a turnover, and wins it back.
23.
And Enigenberg on the attack. Transition offense for Kelvin. Out in front, Joshua Moyer, and a save. Aiden Murphy was there to get in front. Kelvin holds on to the ball. That's DeSarbo. Trying to move his way on in with a burst. Through the right wing. Behind the net. Clippity-clopping. And now up top, that is Gage. Trying to push on in. Here's Moyer, a shot in off the goalie. That'll be a save. I think that was actually, I said Gage, that was Bledsoe who had it. Now here's Blackman trying to wrap around and just missed the far post. Calvin will hold on. We have yet to have a penalty in this game. So the fact that I just said it probably means we've got one coming up. 1:50 to go, first quarter. DeSarbo getting checked. Coming right in on net, and a goal! It deflected off the goalie's leg and ricocheted back into the net, and it's 3-1.
Knights goal, Riley DeSarbo!
Hansen and Dylan Anderson again in the face-off circle. Battle for it. And again, well, it comes loose. Let's see. It'll be won by Calvin. And here come the Knights. Kohler. The ground ball was scooped up by Drew Garrison a moment ago. 3-1, Kelvin. Just over a minute left, first quarter. Blackman, cross field to Jordan Warners.
1 minute.
Kelvin can, for the most part, play for the last shot if they want. About a 6-7 second differential between game clock and shot clock. It looks like they're going to take some time. Warner's just kind of walking his way. Being marked man on man. Evan Watanabe was on him. Warner's juking, jiving. Coming right in on net. A shot and a low shot, and it got blocked by the defender. Blackman has it. 10 on the shot clock. Warners. Pass in front toward Moyer. It's going to go out of bounds. There'll be a turnover by the Knights. So 7 on the game clock. That'll turn it over. The Cardinals will have to rush it up the field. And they'll go with a long bomb pass up the field. And intercepted by Calvin. Here's a late last shot. And it'll be saved.
And your score at the end of 1, Calvin Knights 3, North Central College Cardinals 1.
We intercepted and cranked it, but it forced the goalie Murphy to come out and smother it.
Push me, and then just touch me, till I can get my satisfaction.
I think our statisticians are going to give that shot to Josh, beg your pardon, Ethan Bullets.
Satisfaction.
I'll try to get you updates on baseball. Calvin leading 1-0 at Olivet. They are in the first inning. See if I can't get you a men's volleyball score. Women's lacrosse won't start for another 40 minutes. They're at Aurora University today. Trying to get back into the win column. Looks like Olivet up 21-20 in the first set on Calvin. Three to one here, Zydema Field. So Hansen in the face-off circle with 37, Zach Kayaba. One by Kelvin Hansen again, and then got turned over. North Central on the attack, and that shot was partially blocked. They still have possession out in front. Whirling and shot never got through, got blocked by the defense. Loose ball comes back to North Central. Jude Vitale. And here come the Cardinals. Charlie Snyder. Behind the net, and it's going to get away from McQueary, a turnover. Actually, that wasn't McQueary, that was Vitale. Clear attempt for Kelvin, and that's Bolins on the feed from Schomburg. And Kelvin quickly moving the ball upfield. Good ball movement, Smith from Moyer. A week from today, Kelvin will have its MIAA opener, and it'll be right here, 1 o'clock, against the Adrian Bulldogs. Christian Kohler. Again, Kelvin has had a lot of the ball in this game thus far. Warners to Kohler. Good ball movement. Smith from the left side. Behind the net. Finds Carpenter. We'll have to run it down. Back to Warners. Pass, actually technically a shot, and it'll be speared out of the air by Murphy, the goalie. North Central on the clear. And that will be a successful clear. Charlie Snyder will patiently bring the ball back to DeCunha. Ryan McQueary. To DeCunha, behind the net. Pass up top. Turning is Eberhardt. Shot from a tight angle, and it's going to go well wide. That was DeCunha into the snow, and North Central still has it. 17 on the shot clock. Kind of a cold, damp, gray day, but great weather for Lacrosse. Pass over the top, chase for the ball, and North Central come up with it. Time ticking down on the shot clock. 4-3, now we've got a penalty flag out, so I think that will go on Kelvin as the shot clock horn goes off. And I guess a cross check on
Kelvin
Bolins.
Penalty. That'll be a slash on Ethan.
A
Bolins.
Slash. So a man up opportunity for North Central. So the shot clock resets. DeCunha. Man up opportunity. DeCunha again, a shot and a goal. Came from the right wing.
Cardinals goal, Joey DeCunha. With the
inside the
Charlie Snyder.
Upper left post. Top shelf. As Ken Cal would say, up where they keep the Jiffy peanut butter. It makes it 3-2. He's the voice of the Detroit Red Wings. Unfortunately, the Red Wings have not put the puck in the top shelf up where the Jiffy peanut butter is kept as of late. Probably going to miss the playoffs. A bit of a slide here at the wrong time of the year. Face off, and it's going to be won by North Central. Loose ball. Let's see who's going to get it. Battle for it. Still a battle for it. Kelvin has it. Carpenter then got bumped off the ball. And what do we have here?
Illegal pick.
So an illegal pick, I guess, on North Central. So Kelvin will hold on to the ball. 3-2, Kelvin in the lead. About 11:20 left, second quarter. Kelvin led 3-1 after one. North Central, the man-up goal a moment ago. Bledsoe had it. Now Moyer, one hopper to DeSarbo. He's trying to bulldoze his way to the net. Not getting much gain there against Lenarich. So he'll go back behind the net. Bledsoe. Oh, pass got away from. And we're going to have a turnover by Kelvin. It was Griffith who misplayed it. So the Cardinals on the attack. Coming from behind us, McKinney. Chuck McKinney, oh, a big whack, and the ball is loosened. But North Central comes up with the ground ball, Eberhardt. Here's a shot from the left wing and goes up high. North Central will hang on to it. 51 on the shot clock. Volleyball, Olivet took the first set from Kelvin, 25-23. And those pesky Comets are leading Kelvin in baseball 2-1 in the first right now. The University of Olivet. Here's a shot and a kick save by Schaumburg. A good one. North Central hangs onto it. Charlie Snyder and shot clock reset there as that one was on frame. DeCunha. Moving through the right side. Twisting, turning. Now McQuarrie with it. So North Central hanging on to possession of the ball now. Something Kelvin did a lot in the first quarter. Yes. A double team, loose ball. North Central come up with that ground ball. Quick snapshot and a goal. Oh, no. Unfortunate situation, Charlie Snyder. Kelvin's defense pinched in, created the loose ball, but Snyder jumped on it and had space to shoot and went up high and fired it home, and we are tied 3-3. Well, it's going to take 60 minutes of concentration here for the Knights if they want to come out victorious. Very talented North Central team, 7-0, the Cardinals. North Central win that face-off. Loose ball right now. It's still loose. And coming up with it is, well, that was Kelvin for a moment. That was Engbers who got it. Battle for it along the wing. Still loose. Still loose. Still batted around. And North Central finally comes up with it. I think that was Jake Paris who was wearing 24 in this game. North Central on the clear. And again, the Cardinals with possession of the ball. Long bomb pass and getting a piece of it. Oh, that'll stay with, it was Josh Gage who got a piece of it. It'll stay with North Central. I think that was the right call. It was right in front of us. Deflected out of bounds by Kelvin. It's the FedEx truck. Goes back behind the field. Not sure what's being delivered here on a Saturday on Kelvin's campus. North Central on the attack again, though. DeCunha. Pass out in front. And what do we have here? I think it's going to be Kelvin Ball. It'll be a turnover on North Central. And here comes Kelvin on the clear. So the Knights get the ball back finally. It was August Bryan who brought the ball up the field. Coming in, Kohler with a burst of speed. The junior out of New York shot near side, and he got dumped to the deck. And a push, I think, on North Central. So Calvin will hang on to the ball. Behind the net, Warner's now. From Carpenter. Warner's really getting bumped off the ball. One hands it from his knees and gets it to Thomas Smith. Smith in the slot there, and a shot goes wide by Moyer. Moyer has been working hard to get some space, and he's being tightly defended. He's doing the dirty work, playing out in front of the crease there, and he takes a beating from the defense. Pass behind the net. Kohler from a tight angle off the post. Stays with Calvin. Resets the shot clock. Kohler. Shot from a tight angle and it got blocked. Smothering that one was the defender, Tucker Hansen. Shot goes wide. Knights maintain possession. 29 on the shot clock. Blackman, underhanded shot. That's going to go wide. Stays with Calvin again, but getting late in the shot clock, 18 to be exact. Looks like a zone defense for North Central right now. Just kind of swallowing up the attack. 10 on the shot clock. Smith, a shot, and never got through. Blocked by a defender. Battle for the ball. They reset the shot clock. And I think that's Calvin's Blackman who's got it. The Knights enjoying the possession then. Warner's looking out in front. A shot and a goal. Oh, that was pretty. Christian Kohler on the feed from Warner's. And the Calvin offensive side and the sideline jumps for joy. 4-3, Calvin back on top.
Hard work pays off. That's a goal for Christian Kohler with the assist from Jordan Warners.
Face off, and it's going to be won by North Central. Look out, coming the other way, loose ball. And now a turnover, won by Calvin. That's Micah Vandenberg on the play. What do we have here? A timeout taken by Calvin. Or North Central with a timeout.
North Central. Get on my elevator. Baby, we're going up. Give me that now and later. So much to discover. Please don't stop me now. Every time I touch it, they're front of the ground. Let them go. All the ones trying to get in the door. I will go where they all couldn't go. Up a floor, up a floor, up a floor. Oh, I know we can get.
So 4-3. It's been a tense one here at Zytema Field. 4:54 left in the second quarter. You don't know what's standing in front of me. Coming to slay all my enemies. Enemies, not only me, it's the army. I'm standing on snakes, whatever the case, cause I got the upper hand. Yeah, yeah. I got the power, 24 hours, and that's all 7. Yeah, 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 yeah. So North Central out of the timeout. We'll control the ball. Here come the Cardinals. A shot well high and off the top of the net. Underhanded golf shot, if you will. Pass to the top. Riley McQueary trying to move on in and kind of lost his bearings, and that one went way wide. McQueary out of Washington, Illinois. Bulk of this North Central team out of Illinois, but they got some other out-of-staters. Try to go through some of those here. Calvin, of course, the same. As far as a good chunk from the state of Michigan, but then quite a few other states also represented. Always enjoy playing the where are they from game when I go through rosters. Play a little geography teacher. Here's a shot. Going to go high and wide. 3:56 in the shot game clock, 22 in the shot clock. Got a couple of former teammates here. The Bolins brothers out of Grays Lake Central High School. Turnover by North Central. Calvin with it. They're from Grays Lake Central, and Mason Russo out of Grays Lake Central on this North Central team, also from that high school. And of a foul on the Cardinals, so Calvin on the clear. Looks like it's going to be a good one. It's like an interference call on North Central. Nick Griffith with it. Now he finds DeSarbo. 4-3, Calvin. 3 minutes, 15 seconds left, second quarter. This is part of a three-game homestand for the Knights. Started last week, last Saturday, against Benedictine. Continues today, and will conclude next Saturday at home here against Adrian. DeSarbo trying to turn. Couldn't get a good look at goal. Pulls the ball back. And another look, and a shot goes wide. That was Blackman from a tight angle. Looks like I've got to fix that scheduled date. Kelvin will play at Hope on the Tuesday after next weekend, but it says April 7. That's not a correct date. It is a Tuesday night. I think it's April 10 is the... Might be April 9, actually. Might be the date of that one. Pass goes wayward. It'll be a turnover by Kelvin, so here comes North Central the other way. 2:25 left, second quarter. Clear attempt for the Cardinals. 4-3 Knights. Pass through the middle. We're going to have a good clear attempt for the Cardinals. Yesterday, Kelvin baseball swept a doubleheader from Olivet. Softball split a doubleheader with Chicago. Men's volleyball, an exciting win over Adrian.
And a half. 2 minutes.
Here's a shot. Going to go high from a tight angle. McQueary again stays with North Central. 41 on the shot clock. Turnover by the Cardinals. Here comes Jude Vitale. Turnover by the Knights. Tight angle, a shot and a goal. Oh, and it was one-on-one from the right wing.
Cardinals goal.
Luke
Ilgen.
Ilgen beat Schaumburg. 23 got the goal. It's 4-4 with 1:36 to go.
1:36. Okay, so fourth hand turnover caused by who?
11
for them?
Yeah. And 11 had the ground ball, so. 37 or 9.
Face off, 37.
Face-off will be won by North Central.
37-1 and 37 got the ground ball.
Yep. Turnover 37. Forced by 20.
Be another turnover, and that time by North Central. And Kelvin gets the ball and calls timeout with 1:20 on the game clock, 78 on the shot clock. So Knights can basically play for the last shot. Volleyball leading 14-12 in set two against Olivet. Kelvin tied right here, 4-4. Women's lacrosse will start in about 10 minutes at Aurora. Knights can more or less play for the last shot. And then a tie game. You'd love to do
one
just
minute,
that.
1 minute.
A minute left here in the first half. Well, chance for a shot right there by Carpenter, and he came winding around the corner and cranked it wide. Some principles in lacrosse that have some elements of soccer, some hockey, a little bit of basketball. Here's a shot. Oh, and off the helmet. And a race for the ball, and it'll go to North Central. North Central goalie made the big save and got to the ball first, or got closest to the ball as it departed out of bounds. Oh, a near turnover, and pinching in is Carpenter. Still a scramble for the ball. 20 seconds left. North Central in the clear, and Kelvin pinching in. Loose ball, still in the far corner. Who's got it? North Central does. Transition, long bomb pass. Six on the shot clock, and that one goes wide. We'll say that's a shot. Three in the shot clock, or game clock. 3-2-1, and intercepted by Kelvin and cleared down the field. So at halftime, we are tied 4-4. Been an exciting half. Kelvin led 3-1. North Central has scored three of the last four goals. And we are all square at the break. We'll be back in just a moment. We'll try to get you some halftime stats and go from there.
day it is here. Welcome to Grand Rapids Christian High School, where today the curtain does rise on Calvin University football.
We've been dreaming about this our whole lives. The whole world's been wondering, what is Calvin football, right? What is Calvin football? Today, men, we get to show it. Let's go turn this thing up, man.
Here come the Knights. Straight back to throw out of the gun as Pryor lofts it in the end zone. And touchdown. Deter to Kreiner. 20 seconds to go. Pryor again avoids the rush. Enzo, and it is a touchdown. Hunter Hogan on the jump ball. Sky.
Catchers on three. 1, 2, 3. Down.
the world. Captain John.
Ready to go here. Second half, quickly going through some stats as far as total shots. Schubert. 25 for Kelvin, 17 for North Central. Faceoffs. Each team is 5 for 10 on faceoffs. Clears, Kelvin 9 of 12. Beg your pardon, Kelvin 5 of 8, North Central 9 of 12. North Central, 1-for-1 on the extra man opportunity. Kelvin's Corgan Schaumburg with 3 saves, and Aiden Murphy of North Central with 8 saves. Ready to go here, second half, third quarter to be exact. 4-4 is our score. Hanson going up against 37's Kiava, and Kiava wins it. North Central going. From right to left. And they'll hang on to the ball. It's like Kelvin volleyball win the second set, 25-18. Baseball's down 4-1. And a shot and a goal. And just like that, North Central strikes first in the opening moments of the third quarter.
Cardinals goal, Tom Eberhardt.
Eberhardt with a goal. DeCunha with the assist. And that one came 39 seconds into the third. These faceoffs are crucial. Hanson getting a piece of it. Battle for it. North Central get to it quickly. That was Paris. Came up with a ground ball. And again, the Cardinals starting to enjoy possession of the ball here. They now lead it 5-4. It was 3-1 Kelvin, and now North Central scored 4 of the last 5 goals. They've got some momentum on their side. Pass out in front, a one-timer goes wide of the cage. That'll be a turnover. They said that was a pass, not a shot. I think I agree with that call, so it'll be Kelvin ball.
So turnover 3 and 4.
Micah Vandenberg trying to clear it. And there's Bolins. Actually, that was not Bolins. That was Josh Gage. Yeah, I think I have one other card here. Oh, it was in a... There's a shot. It's going to go wide. Yeah.
I wanna turn the whole thing upside down. I'll find the things they say just can't be found. I'll share this love I find with everyone. We'll sing and dance to Mother Nature's song.
That was a shot and a score by David Blackman. Sorry, I had to tend to a few technical equipment issues here. So a big answer by Kelvin, and we are tied 5-5. Face-off. Be won by the Cardinals. And again, that's Jake Paris.
Drum ball, not yet.
Turnover by North Central, and Kelvin will come up with it. Moyer. It's Enigenberg with it.
It was 10. And forced by, I believe it was 24. Okay, ground ball. Yeah, I think so.
Ball going around the horn, 5-5 right now. Blackman scoring just a bit ago. Bledsoe. Left wing to Blackman. Oh, and Moyer got decked. A little slow to get up. Oh, losing the ball there, and unfortunate turnover by Kelvin. Here comes North Central the other way. Murphy, the goalie, triggers it. It was Griffith who was making the attack into the crease area and just had the ball pop out. We got an offside call on North Central. Be a turnover. Kelvin in transition. McKinney, the Trebuckle Hills High School graduate. I think his parents are here in attendance. What do we have here?
Star ball.
McKinney will come off. Kohler coming on. Still a discussion. It's like a women's lacrosse game right now. They're discussing the shot clock. It says 80 right now. Not sure that's going to be correct. So they're going to change it up. Tied up 5-5, 10 and 20 left. Third quarter. Blackman. The Warners. And Kohler and Smith. Carpenter behind the net. Return pass. Good save by Moyer. Thomas Smith fakes a shot, goes high and a little wide. Shot by Smith and saved by the goalie Murphy. Cardinals on the clear.
Yeah.
5-5 here in the third. Shot attempt and a good defensive double team by Kelvin forces that turnover as a shot was attempted and Bolins comes up with the ground ball. Kelvin on the clear. And a goal by the Knights, David Blackman. The Knights take the 6-5 lead.
That's another goal from David Blackman, assisted by Nick Griffith.
Griffith on the assist.
Oh, big knee.
Women's lacrosse underway, trailing 1-0. Beg your pardon, 2-2 in the first now. Just kind of went from early in the game to about 6 minutes into the game. Going to be a turnover by North Central. So the Knights win on the faceoff violation. Chance to add to that 6-5 lead. Bledsoe. That's Griffith. Got a screen from Moyer. One hop feed to Blackman behind the net. Lost it. Murphy, the goalie, comes up with it. Clear attempt by the Cardinals. Successful clear. Pass to the right point. Bit of speed, Snyder a shot and saved, and in the crease and smothering it is Schomburg. Pick up that ground ball and start the attack. Clear attempt for Kelvin. That was Micah Vandenberg to McKinney. Now Christian Kohler. Jordan Warners. Now it's Blackman. Kohler to Moyer, who's playing up top right now. Smith, little juke and a jive, a shot. It's going to go wide. All right. I think there's another battery that is plugged in down there by the charger. Okay. Blackman coming right in on net and a save by Murphy, the goalie. 14 on the shot clock. Yeah, you got Kelvin crowd calling for a reset. Warner's left to crank it, and it's going to go wide. And that will pretty much turn the ball back over to North Central. Kelvin, 5.5 to go. Third quarter. It was 4-4 at halftime. It was 3-1 Kelvin after one, and 4-4 at half, and now 6-5 here, midway through the third. Actually, about two-thirds of the way through the third. Got to do my math. There's a shot, and it's going to go wide. battle for the ball out in front. And a ground ball by August Bryan. That shot was by McQueary. Kelvin on the clear. Bryan racing through the center. Pass goes up high and Blackman will spear it down. .440 left in the third. 6-5 Kelvin. Playing the patient game on offense right now. Pass to the top. Bledsoe a shot and a save. A good one by Murphy. Went down on his knees. Get a piece of that one. DeSarbo. A shot. And it's going to go wide as he split two defenders. And North Central is going to get to that ball first. That goalie is quick, Murphy. And they'll win possession. A Cardinal clear. And here comes McQueary. Finds Charlie Snyder. Now McQueary again. Successful clear, and the Cardinals will set up shop. About 53 on the shot clock. Oh, 3:45 on the game clock. Quick pass, a shot and a goal. That was Tom Eberhardt in the slot. Snagged it and flicked it down on the one hopper, and it eluded Schaumburg. And we are tied at 6. Tough 1-2 combo to stop if you're on the defensive side. We're tied at 6. Volleyball, Kelvin up 20-16 in the third against Olivet. Baseball down 4-2 in the fourth at Olivet. Let's see, women's lacrosse. Aurora leads 3-2 with about 6 minutes left in the first. Face-off, won by Kelvin. And it's Kohler on the ground ball. 6-6, Kelvin in transition. A shot, and it goes wide. It was Drew Garrison. Don't see him shooting the ball that often, but in a transition play like that, he had his opportunity. Thomas Smith. This game has turned into a cat and mouse game. Both teams playing back on defense, not allowing much in transition. It's been a half court game, if you will. Kohler a shot in, it went off the crossbar. And high and up against the net will be Kelvin hanging on to the ball. That had some pace on it. Skimmed off the crossbar. Smith finds Blackman. Back to Smith. A shot from a tight angle and a goal. Nice quick combo pass. Blackman to Smith. And the Knights are in the lead, 7-6 with 2:42 left in the third. Women's lacrosse now 4-2. Aurora out in front of Kelvin. Face off here, Hansen bowling his way up front. Still a battle for it, and I think we're going to have a violation, or a foul actually, on the face off. Kelvin will win that ball. So Hansen doing his job. And he's got the ball. You can score and then win the face off right after. That is huge for momentum. Jacob Bledsoe on it. Shot out in front on a goal! Bledsoe, a quick 1-2 combination with Carpenter. And it's a 2-goal lead, and let's go! .825 8-6. Got some fans out here doing a little Saturday Night Fever dancing.
Brayden Carpenter with the assist from Joshua Moyer.
Got to get out the late 1970s disco style leisure suits. And another face-off violation on North Central. Oh, nope, sorry, it was on Kelvin. Thought it was going the other way. So I stand corrected, but a two-goal lead for Kelvin late in the third. 2 minutes and 10 seconds left. North Central in possession. Cardinals, shot blocked, never got through. Battle for the ground ball. Who's got it? Schaumburg has it. That shot by Snyder was just snuffed out. Kelvin really staying guided to its defensive principles. Here's a quick one-hop pass, and what a snag in traffic by Joshua Moyer. The Allentown, Pennsylvania lad. Former state champion as a high school lacrosse player. He's just going to hang on to the balls. The Knights will take some time in the offensive attack. They like to say in basketball, taking air out of the ball. There's not a lot of air in a lacrosse ball, so can't really use that metaphor.
Works, works.
Behind the net, Braden Carpenter looking for someone, and unfortunately, that's going to go up near midfield. And a turnover by the Knights. So the Cardinals in transition, under a minute to go. Riley McQueary. Charlie Snyder. A pass and a shot. Off the goalpost, gets his rebound, and a shot goes wide. It was DeCunha with back-to-back shots. And it's going to be Kelvin Ball. Schaumburg got there first. Kelvin can run out the clock here at the end of the third. Transition. That is Enigenberg. In transition, he got decked. Here's a shot and a save out of the air. That was Warner's. And Murphy, a long bomb pass way downfield and over the goal as the horn sounds. Well, so the Knights with a two-goal lead at 8-6.
End of three, Calvin Knights 8, North Central College Cardinals 6.
Kelvin Volleyball taking set number 3, 25-19, so up 2-1, bidding for a second straight win for the first time all year. Baseball trailing 4-3 in the fourth. Women's lacrosse down 5-2 late in the first period. Stats here. Aiden Murphy with 11 saves. Corgan Schaumburg with 5. Shots, Kelvin dominating in that regard, 42-24. As far as goals are scored, North Central, Tom Eberhart with a pair, Charlie Snyder with a pair, one apiece for DeCunha and Ilgen. Kelvin has 2 goals apiece from Thomas Smith, David Blackman, Blackman with a couple of assists, 2 goals for Christian Kohler, a goal for Braden Carpenter, and a goal for Riley DeSarbo. Kelvin's Nate Hansen, 8 of 17 on faceoffs. And Zach Cuyaba is 9 of 15 on faceoffs for North Central. Dylan Anderson, 0 of 2. Ready to go, fourth quarter. Kelvin in the lead, 8 to 6 against an undefeated North Central team.
Here we go, first down.
Faceoff won by Kelvin, and then Kohler got decked, and he comes up with the ball. Kelvin going from right to left.
Shot.
And a shot and a goal. And Kelvin has a 3-goal lead.
That's a nice goal from Bryn Carpenter with the assist from David Blackman.
Carpenter and Blackman on the combo. 9-6. And a face-off win. And here's the diesel right in on that and a shot and a save.
That would have been beautiful. That would have been so sweet. I want to hear my son's goal song too.
Did they get a ground ball?
Cardinals coming right back on the clear. Joey DeCunha. Now he's got McQueary. Spinning his way, trying to get in on net. Charlie Snyder. Kelvin defense. Chuck McKinney is part of that. And a loose ball out in front and a ground ball taken by Schomburg. Good defense out in front by Kelvin. And here comes Kelvin on the clear. August Bryan. Kelvin in possession, up 3 goals. Still fairly early in the fourth, a lot of time left. Ooh, pass going to get away, and that's an unfortunate turnover by Griffith. An unforced turnover. It gives the ball right back to North Central with 13 left in the quarter. Tristan Windham. Or beg your pardon, that wasn't Windham, that was Charlie Snyder looking at the wrong roster. Turnover though by North Central. And coming up with it for Kelvin is Dylan Mount. 25, Dylan Mount with a ground ball. And the clear attempt is good. Now let's see if the Knights can maintain possession of the ball. DeSarbo on the attack and takes the pass on the ground. Shoots and a save. Off the chest. Murphy with it. Battle for it. And North Central comes up with the ground ball. Rutger Rawlings gets it to Murphy. And here comes the Cardinals on the clear. Almost lost it. Keeping it in play there was Tucker Hansen. Look out. North Central in transition. Kelvin getting back on defense. It was August Bryan getting back in position. Justin Riddle tightly defending. Luke Paris. .11:30 left in the fourth quarter. Kelvin up 9-6 on North Central. And an intercept. I thought that was intercepted, and it was by Josh Gage. Oh, look out. Gage got the stick knocked down for a moment. Got the ball right back. Clear attempt for Kelvin to Enningenberg. Western Michigan Christian High School graduate. Finds Warners to Carpenter, right wing. It's pushed from behind. Hangs on to the ball. Blackman. Tight angle and a shot and a save. Murphy. And he'll cover up and start the attack. 10:45 left in this one. 9-6 Kelvin. Long bomb pass, and he's got his man. Look out. Here comes Zachary Corsell. A shot, and it goes wide from a tight angle.
He was in the crease.
I think they're going to say the attacker was in the crease. And he was. That'll turn the ball over. It's on Ilgen. Kelvin will get the ball back and on the clear. Momentum continues to stay with Kelvin. And a good clear attempt, Christian Kohler. Ten minutes left, fourth quarter. 9-6 Kelvin, Thomas Smith.
So do I.
I wish I had
a shot, and it goes wide. It'll stay with the Knights.
That's what he said. I love you, but. I mean, man crush type. I mean, I'm not looking weird. Of the energy.
Pass out front and right out in front of the net and a goal.
24 from 35.
Carpenter gives Kelvin a 4-goal lead. And we are dancing the night away. He's got himself a hat trick at this point. That was Moyer on the assist.
9:41.
BG's forever, folks.
Hey, if you heard that song three times, that means it's a hat trick for Brayden Carpenter. The assist from Joshua Moyer.
Face off, Hansen. Gets dumped, and he's going to win that face off on the push by North Central. You love to see it. Kelvin holding on to the ball and a 4-goal lead with 9.5 to go in this one. Christian Kohler finds Blackman. Knights in no hurry right now. Shot by Bledsoe goes wide. 49 on the shot clock. Still Kelvin ball. Kelvin 6-3 right now. Bidding to go to 7-3. That was Griffith. Feet up top, Carpenter. Oh, a nifty spin, a shot, and off the hop. Comes right to Murphy, and here comes North Central. Cardinals down 4. Hansen, Tucker Hansen, that is. Out of Minneapolis, Minnesota. And a timeout taken by North Central. Get you caught up on some scores here.
Shoot a shot. Beep, beep, beep. I'm coming in.
Volleyball, Kelvin up 11-7 in the fourth set, trying to close out a win over Olivet. Baseball down 4-3 in the fifth at Olivet. Women's lacrosse down 6-3 at Aurora early in the second period. And I think that is it for Kelvin Athletics right now. Softball got postponed today by the weather. Field got washed out at Wheaton. I got to be honest, I have not even looked at the early portion of the schedule next week because it was such a crunch this weekend with home events. Can tell you that next week, April 1 to 7, is NCAA D3 week. Why D3 will be the hashtag. We will be celebrating our Kelvin student athletes on campus, both with events on campus, but also online. So check our social media handles, the X, Kelvin Knights, Instagram, Kelvin Knights. Go on Facebook, Kelvin Knights Facebook page. We've got a TikTok channel. We'll have some Instagram takeovers, some graphics, stories on KelvinKnights.com, all sorts of stuff. So look for content all throughout next week celebrating YD3. And just talking about our great Calvin athletes, both present and past. Here's a shot, and it's going to go wide. Charlie Snyder, North Central, hang on to it. 8:14 left in the fourth. North Central trying to get one back. Knights have to be disciplined, as they have for this entire game up to this point. Look out, a shot and a great save by Schomburg on the bullet ball from Snyder. He read that one like a book. It went up high and snagged it. Kelvin on the clear. Warner's a shot. Got belted as he let it go, and it was the North Central goalie Murphy taking his chances out of the cage and getting closest to the ball. As it went out of bounds, it'll be Cardinal ball. Under eight to go. Here in the fourth, 10-6, Kelvin. Moyer back checking. All over the goalie, and he'll just have to whip it long. And over his teammate's head and out of bounds, turnover to Kelvin. North Central. Tom Eberhardt's, North Central's Tom Eberhardt, trying to claim he was held there. He's not going to get a call. Here comes Kelvin the other way. Josh Gage on the clear to Bolins. And it's a good clear. You can hear our man outside doing play-by-play for us. He's doing some dancing. He's doing some commentating. Jordan Warners. Young freshman out of California. Twisting, turning. Oh, got his man on skates there and shot the ball wide. It'll stay with Kelvin. 6:40 to go. Blackman. Carpenter. Twisting, turning, right in on that and a goal. Ho, ho, ho. Play that music, Sam. Play it again, Sam. For the fourth time, Carpenter with his fourth goal of the game, and Kelvin leads it 11-6. Of course, that line comes from the famous movie Casablanca. Humphrey Bogart saying, "Play it again, Sam."
With his fourth goal, and David Blackman with another assist. That's his fourth assist.
Face off 37 over 9.
Yes, sir.
Thank you. Women are getting destroyed 8-3.
That's another push.
Another face-off and a push on North Central, and Cardinals are starting to get frustrated as this game is slipping away. They have not tasted defeat yet this year. So frustration starting to creep in on the Cardinal sideline. It's part of athletics sometimes. DeSarbo, boy, is he quick and shifty. Comes in and a save, a rebound, and we're going to have a penalty, I think, on North Central. Oh, maybe. The flag came down. What's going to be the call? Moyer got decked as he picked up the ground ball and was going for the rebound shot. Going to say a push or a cross check. A 60-second penalty, unnecessary roughness.
Cardinals penalty on Dominic Rohr, unnecessary.
Dominic Rohr, the guilty party, so the Knights with a man-up opportunity with 6:03 to go and a 5-goal lead. Knights can just kind of play keep away right now. Kohler, a shot and a save, a good one by Murphy, and he scoops it up. Under six to go. 5:35 to be exact. North Central in transition. They're down five. Pass out in front of shot. And a good save by Schaumburg. Rebound shot. No. Never got it off. And Kelvin in transition. Schaumburg coming up big. Boy, he's had himself a game. Kelvin still up a man. Timeout. No, we have a turnover on Kelvin. So North Central with under five to go. McQuarrie has it. Ball batted around. Loose ball. Ground ball. Ethan Bolins. Schaumburg with it. And Kelvin on the clear. 4:25 left. Kelvin up 11-6. The Knights on the clear. A couple of Kelvin Ducks coming in for a landing over there. Coming right over top. That's actually geese. Got a couple of ponds near this field here, so we can get some waterfowl in the area. It's a shot by Smith, and it's going to go wide. 3:39 left.
Yep, that's what we got.
Warner's pass out in front. Got deflected. Blackman lost his stick and then kicks the ball, and that'll turn it over to North Central. Here come the Cardinals. On the clear. They're down five. Still time left, but they'll have to get something going here soon. Kelvin defense has been pretty good today. It's held this high-scoring North Central attack in check. Look out, North Central coming in on net and a goal. As we're talking, coming in was Luke Ilgen, and he fires at home.
That's his second.
3 minutes.
So 11-7 with exactly 3 minutes to go. It is not over yet. It's like Kelvin baseball has taken a 5-4 lead on Olivet. Kelvin volleyball up 23-12 in the fourth and about ready to get its second straight win. Women's lacrosse was down 8-3 last look and still down 8-3 in the second at Aurora. Going to have a face-off win for North Central, so look out. A last gasp here by the Cardinals. Kelvin defense has to lock in. Shot from a tight angle and a one-timer off the feed goes high and wide. 2:41 to go. Another one out in front. Never got through, and Schaumburg jumps on the loose ball. They were trying to find Eberhardt there. And Bolins sandwiched down. Loose ball. Who's going to come up with it? Kelvin will. And here comes Kelvin on the clear. That was Josh Gage who snuck in there. Made the play. Thomas Smith. Kelvin in the lead, and they've got the ball under two to go. Knights are in the catbird seat right now. Wait Christian Kohler just running a circle around this North Central defense. Running laps, burning calories, and burning off seconds at the same time. Well, they have plenty of opportunity to eat Easter dinner tomorrow. 120, he's still got the ball. Five on the shot clock. I think they're just going to turn it over and set up the defense. Just killing clock, 111 left. Four-goal Kelvin lead. Kelvin's sideline, very animated right now. Here come the Cardinals.
1 minute, 1 minute.
In transition.
Yes.
Oh, and a sandwich. That was Bolins who ran into Ilgen and the Knights with a turnover. The other way. Here come the Knights. Under a minute to go. Carpenter. The Warner shot from the near post, smothered by Murphy. North Central is under a minute to go. Dominic Rohr gets the pass off. 30 seconds left. In the slot, trying to bull his way through, and it's just not going to happen. Oh, Bolin's lost a wide open net and an easy goal for North Central. Luke Ilgen on the turnover by the goalie, I believe.
Cardinals goal, Luke Ilgen. That's a hat trick for him today.
23, I believe.
It's
23 that
scored it,
Bruce?
Yeah.
On an empty net. With 20 seconds left. But it's a three-goal Kelvin lead at 11-8. And the Knights are going to win this one. They are dancing over there on the sideline. Face off, time ticking down, one by Kelvin. 5 seconds, 4 seconds, well, beg your pardon, I was off a few seconds. Now we're down to 10 seconds. Long bomb pass on the clear. And that's gonna go deep, it'll be a turnover with 4 seconds left. Four seconds, 3 seconds, 2 seconds, 1 second, and Kelvin has won 11-8, and they storm the field. They knock off the undefeated, previously undefeated, North Central Cardinals, 11-8. One of the bigger wins for Coach Dave Holger in his tenure. It's a North Central side that went to the NCAA tournament just 2 years ago. And it's tradition rich. And the Cardinals beat Kelvin 17-9 a year ago. And Kelvin winning this one 11-8. And it was a true team effort. It really was. Really started with the defense being very disciplined and getting this one done. It's going to feel awfully good to head coach Dave Holger. And we've got the stats here. Go through them quickly. For North Central, first of all, Joey DeCunha, 2 goals, 3 assists. Oh, take it back. 1 goal and 2 assists. I was reading it wrong. Luke Ilgen with a hat trick, 3 goals. 2 goals and 1 assist for Charlie Snyder. And that is pretty much it for Kelvin. Thomas Smith, 2 goals and 1 assist. David Blackman, 2 goals, 4 assists. 2 goals for Christian Kohler. 4 goals for Brandon Carpenter. An assist for Jordan Warners. 2 assists. For Joshua Moyer, and 1 goal for Riley DeSarbo. Let's see, face-offs for Kelvin. Nate Hansen, 13 of 23. Corgan Schomburg, 7 saves. As far as the ground balls are concerned, 8 for Corgan Schomburg, 5 for Braden Carpenter, 5 for Joshua Moyer, 5 for David Blackman. Ethan Bolins caused 4 turnovers. Braden Carpenter forced 2 turnovers. 3 caused turnovers for Josh Gage and Corgan Schomburg. So a great defensive effort for the Knights. They are going to feel real good about this one going into Easter weekend. And now they've got a week to prepare for their MIAA opener, which will be a week from today, 1 o'clock, against the Adrian Bulldogs. And remember, it's a Kelvin team that did not qualify for the 4-team MIAA tournament last year. They'll be very motivated to finish in the top 4 and get back to that league tournament. Well, I want to thank Justin Kendall and his outstanding staff yet again, doing double duty. We have men's lacrosse here, men's volleyball going on right now. Looks like the volleyball team just finished out a four-set win over Olivet. So congrats to Spencer Frederick there. But it takes a lot for our video production team. They had three events yesterday, baseball, softball, men's volleyball, and then two events today, all on a holiday weekend. And they did a superlative job. So, again, thanks to them. They always do do a great job as these two squads get together for post-game prayer, which is very appropriate, especially on this Easter weekend. And we want to send our greetings out to you, make sure that you all have a very blessed Easter tomorrow. And until our next broadcast, which will be a week from today against Adrian, we will say so long.